Good day, everyone. I want to take time for prayer and reflection today. The church celebrates the feast day of Saint Martha. We can all identify with Martha, I know I do in my life, because we can be busy and anxious and worried about many things that are happening today and what we need to get done or what's being prepared for future days ahead. And Martha enters an experience because of offering hospitality to Jesus and others who are at her home. She's offering a gift of food and service and love. And so she's busy about it because she wants it all to be right. And so we hear that account today in Luke's Gospel, chapter 10, verses 38 to 42. And let me offer that in prayer. Jesus entered a village where a woman whose name was Martha welcomed him. She had a sister named Mary, who sat beside the Lord at his feet, listening to him speak. Martha, burdened with much serving, came to him and said, "Lord, do you not care that my sister has left me by myself to do the serving? Tell her to help me." The Lord said to her in reply, "Martha, Martha, you are anxious and worried about many things. There is need of only one thing. Mary has chosen the better part, and it will not be taken from her." The Gospel of the Lord. Martha, Martha, busy with offering that gift of hospitality, wanting to do the best, wanting to offer the Lord her very best. And yet she's anxious. She's worried about doing it. She's concerned that her sister is not helping her. It's not being done right. How often in our lives now, in this COVID time and many other issues before us, we can have those days of busyness. And we can be worried and anxious about many things. I know I can identify with St. Martha many times in my life. I can be worried and anxious about many things. But may we hear Jesus speaking to us as he did to Martha. Maybe he's saying, like to me, "Father Ron, Father Ron, worried and anxious about many things. Listen to me." And I know I find great peace if I can take time to listen to the words of Jesus, offer over those worries and anxieties. Because Martha did listen to Jesus. She faithfully followed him. And in John's Gospel here in chapter 11, verses 19 to 27, that Jesus was there again after Lazarus had died, Martha and Mary's brother. And in performing again that miracle of raising Lazarus to new life, Martha proclaims her beautiful faith in Christ. Because Jesus asked her, "Do you believe that I am the resurrection and the life?" And Martha says to Jesus, "Yes, Lord, I have come to believe that you are the Christ, the Son of God, the one who is coming into the world." May we join Martha in prayer today. May we turn over all that busyness and anxiousness and worry to Jesus, even if it's only a moment of prayer. May we listen to his words, because he's not scolding Martha today. He's welcoming her, welcoming each and every one of us to sit with him, to listen to him, to turn those concerns over to him, because he does indeed hear us, as he heard the prayers of Martha, that he hears us today and every day. And so may we pray that he hear us and that together we may serve one another in love, offer that gift of hospitality, help all of us in this time of great anxiety in our world, that we truly hear the good news of Jesus Christ. God bless all of you.